It's Talk Funny, a podcast by Mark Bailey and other comics from all over. We ended up in Japan because we hate paper towels in restrooms. Yuck, hygiene, who needs it? The Talk Funny podcast from NagoyaRadio.com and Nagoya Comedy. Here's Mark Bailey.
Mark Bailey, Talk Funny. One of the comics I've set before in Tokyo that I really love. There's a comic I played with in Tokyo. He's originally from Israel. He sends me posts from Taiwan and Hong Kong, and it's always him on a yoga mat with him balancing women. Have you seen this?
No.
Balancing women on his feet, and it's a thing or something.
What? That's a thing.
And the women are always ass down, so it's like, yeah, that's just a way for you to look at their butt. They'll call that a sport. That's not going to be in the Olympics.
That's a little bit
unless
weird.
Howard Stern is the Olympic chief, you know, it's not going to be a sport. Chi Sai or some, I don't know what it is. It's not Tai Chi. Chi Sai. Chi Sai Anna. Maybe that's what it's called. Small ass, small butt. But it's just every pose is, there's a cute Asian girl with her butt above your face 3 feet.
I'm sure he does not notice at all.
See what you're doing. Yeah,
he doesn't
notice. What you're doing.
He's telling them it's Krav Maga. Let me show you my culture.
I see what you're doing, Danny Thompson. Without the coffee table, and without the poop. Gilbert Gottfried is laughing from his grave at this joke right now.
He loved that Danny Thomas joke.
You can't fool me, and any girl will see this and go like, yeah, I see there's only young Asian girls with their butts in your face.
Mm-hmm.
I know what you're doing.
We know what you're doing.
I'm surprised this is
OnlyFans.
OnlyFans.
Yeah, OnlyFans.
I was confused then. I'm getting annoyed with the commercials in Japan.
Oh, God, yeah.
They can't use pop music. They can't use patented music. They're ripping off Mozart, Eine kleine Nachtmusik.
Mm-hmm.
They're ripping off Beethoven. Beethoven 5th, Beethoven 9th, mm-hmm. Beethoven 1st. I'm hearing all this. I even heard like Camp Town Lady sing this song. That's the theme song at Top Camera here in Nagoya.
Yes, they play it again and again.
Because it's open source.
It's been that way for years, too.
It's free domain.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking like maybe I should, for my porn site, I'm thinking of maybe making a porn site, and then the theme song will be Kimigayo. But it'll be like Titty Dayo. And that's not a secret song here. It's a national anthem of Japan.
I do not approve of this message to all the Uyoku out
there.
Just
Mike
to let you
Miller.
Know.
He lives near Oslo. You can find him.
I strongly disapprove of this idea. I respect
Dayo.
The emperor.
So, interesting fact about Kimigayo, the sacred, traditional national anthem of Japan.
Yeah.
Was not written by a Japanese.
Really?
No.
Wow.
The melody was written by a Scottish band leader.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So they can't even get a national anthem right.
It's a weird national anthem, too, because it's very, like, it's very low.
They slowed it down.
It's not really a march. Most national anthems are kind of like marches, like Sousa, but it's a kind of a slow.
We will annex Sudetenland. Sudetenland. Yes, we will. Yes, we will.
Overall.
Uber all, Uber eats,
yeah.
Uber drinking.
Yeah, I mean, it is a weird national anthem, and we just heard it a little while ago because they have the emperor's birthday, and there's always a couple of right-wing guys who drive around in the sound trucks blasting that out.
I thought the emperor was sent by God. How many emperors are you guys going to have?
Yeah.
They keep dying. It's like the Pope. The papacy will live on with the Pope and his children and his children and the children after him. But he doesn't have children.
Yeah, it's funny how that works out. Oh, the Pope.
All right, so we have interviews here at the office sometimes. I run some businesses, weddings and things like that. So I had a wedding guy come in for an applicant for weddings. Said, you know, here's the rules. About a minute in, and I said, so some other things, no tennis shoes. You have to show up a certain amount of time before the wedding.
Mm-hmm.
And a few other things that I want to tell you about when you're dealing with the musicians. They're called the Seikatai. And they are not in charge. Because I sent you, you're in charge, so you have to have a little bit of authority.
Yeah.
And he said, do you mind if I go out in the patio to smoke now? And I said, that's a little bit too much authority. In the middle of an interview.
In an interview, he asked you that. Like,
I said, I'm sorry, am I boring you? I said, I'm telling you things that I will fire you for.
Yeah.
You're not interested? He goes, but just a short smoke break. And I said, was that in the ad that I sent you? He goes, I'll be back in 10 minutes. I said,
10 minutes?
I said, I'll thank you for your time. I said, you know what? It's better. You know, this is not a good place to smoke.
Because
the patio
is
kind of unstable. This is before it was renovated.
Yeah.
And it's kind of moldy, and I don't want you to fall. I think it's better if you just leave the building and go behind the building and smoke there and then don't come back. And he goes, no, I mean, I'll come back. I said, no, you won't. So he said, I'll come back for the interview. I said, no, you won't. He said, it's okay. I will continue the interview. I said, how magnanimous of you? Mm. And I said, guess what? The interview's over. He goes, because of that? I'm like, eh, a lot of reasons, you know. I feel like I'm boring you with offering you money for work, you know. And he goes, so can I smoke now? And I said, you can smoke anywhere you want, but not here, right? And then we had another one where I went out on the patio, and it was rotted. And then I went down, and I didn't know there was cement below it.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought I was going down, right? So then the landlord came, loves to talk to me. And he goes, we're going to replace it again. I said, we're doing this every 6 months. How about like something that doesn't rot, like not wood? How about in a country that has rainy seasons? How about no wood patios?
Great idea.
That's a good idea. Unrelated, Sean Lennon and Julian Lennon, mm-hmm. they seem to complain a lot.
Oh, yeah?
You had a story about someone who was related, son or daughter.
We're talking about Richard Pryor's son.
Yeah, Richard Pryor's son. How did that go?
Richard Pryor's son. I just saw this. There was a thing on Reddit a couple of weeks ago, and it was about worst bombs of all time, kind of on our stand-up, which is actually a pretty good, I recommend it if you like Reddit and you're into comedy, check it out, r/stand-up. And they talked about, I think it's Marlon Pryor, who is Richard Pryor's son, and he went to the Apollo, and he was going to do a bit, and it just was not funny.
Apollo is a tough crowd.
Yes, you have your story about the Apollo, which is very, very illustrative, and it's hosted by Steve Harvey. And you could just tell, like, the crowd, they gave him a chance. Even Steve Harvey gave the look, you know, kind of rolled his eyes, and that's when he knew it was over. And he just basically, he couldn't believe it. He was like, what, you're not laughing? Because I'm, I guess he just assumed he would use that name, right, to get a laugh.
Yeah.
And you can watch it on YouTube or somewhere.
He wouldn't have gotten booked without the name Pryor.
No, he wouldn't have gotten, he needed Pryor credentials on that stage.
I've heard Sean Lennon was complaining that the industry doesn't treat him with respect.
Oh, yeah?
You got a record contract, you MF-er.
Yeah.
Because of your last name.
Yeah.
Right? I can't do that.
Yeah.
My, you know.
He's been doing music for years. Like, why is he having trouble now?
I get stopped by police because of my last name, okay? You're lucky you got a contract. The more talented Julian Lennon, a little bit more talented, he's had good success in the 80s. He was complaining that his career is washed up because people always assume he was famous because of his father. What do you mean assume? Of course you are.
We know.
You know, it's like Madonna saying, you know, I think I got a record contract in the 70s because of my big breasts. Okay, you think or you know? Of course you did. Because of the way I look. No. It's your philosophy on life. That's why.
Oh, God.
These guys whining. It's like, look at Stella McCartney. She doesn't whine.
Yeah.
She didn't go into music.
Yeah.
She probably could.
Mm-hmm.
And she'd sell records just because of her name. Mm. But maybe she's talented in the purses and stuff that she does,
yeah.
right?
Is she still around?
Yeah.
She's still around.
Yeah, she's doing well. Mm-hmm. She does good. Well in Tokyo.
Good, good.
But, you know, she has art in her veins, obviously. She can't do music. She'd probably suck at it.
Mm-hmm. Hey.
All right. Mark Bailey, Mike Miller on Talk Funny.